You probably think this world is a dream come true, but you're wrong.
This is why you never go to the well on your own. In 1983, a young boy was camping with his family on Roan Mountain in North Carolina when his mom asked him to head on down the path and get some water from the well. When the boy didn't return, his mom went to check on him and he was gone. A massive search party was launched to find him, but with temperatures rapidly dropping and finding no trace of him, the family braced for the worst. Then, miraculously, on the seventh day of the search, the boy shows up on the mountaintop in an area they had already searched, healthy and clean. When they asked the boy, "Where have you been?" he said he had been at the well when a tall, faceless man showed up behind him, scooped him up, and brought him to the top of the mountain where he kept him in his cabin all week. After the boy gave a very detailed description of exactly where this cabin was on the mountain, the police were eager to go find it and confront this guy. But the park superintendent just raised his hand and said, "Guys, it's pointless. I've worked here 40 years. There are no cabins on Roan Mountain." This is why you should be careful what you put in the mail. In 2015, a man was asked by his neighbor to collect his mail while he was gone for a few weeks. A few days later, a large package arrives on his neighbor's front porch. The man can barely lift it, but gets over to his garage where he accidentally drops it and hears something break inside. Hoping his neighbor would think the damage occurred en route, he closes his squeaky garage door and forgets about it. But over the next couple of days, whatever was in that package started to smell so bad that he decides to open it up. Inside were two very important finds: his neighbor, who was dead, and a camera that was still recording. The police bring the man in for questioning and show him what was on the camera inside the box. It starts with his neighbor talking to the camera about how excited he is to mail himself home for his YouTube channel. Then, police fast forward to the very end where they see that the neighbor is now sleeping in the box, and then suddenly gets dropped and you hear a crack, and that's his neck breaking. And then you hear a squeaky garage door close. This story is why people are scared of the dark. In the early 2010s, a man and his dog were staying at a very isolated cabin in the backcountry of Oregon. One day, he notices some human footprints leading up to and then disappearing away from his cabin, but there aren't any cabins anywhere near his, but he writes it off. That night, he wakes up to the sound of footsteps on his roof. Feeling brave, he heads to the balcony to take a look. He doesn't see anything on the roof, but his dog sees something out in the forest and he starts growling. The man starts to scan the tree line, and then he sees it. A freakishly tall man is squatting on a branch just 20 feet away from his balcony. His arms are outstretched, his mouth is open, no expression on his face. The man, in terror, backs into his house, grabs his dog, shuts the door, shines the light on the branch, but it's gone. Now feeling freaked out, he shuts all the blinds, makes sure all the doors are locked, he gets in his bed, and for the next several hours, he hears tapping on both of the two doors from his friend outside. Remember, your Amazon Alexa is always listening. In 2018, a girl named Alexa came home to her apartment to find her creepy stalker landlord in her kitchen. She screams and threatens to call the cops, and he just smiles and says, "I was just checking in on you," and leaves. Feeling totally sketched out, she spends the next few hours down the hall in her friend's apartment before finally going back to her room to go to bed. That night, she woke up to her Amazon Alexa responding to someone in the room. It said, "I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Did you say I'm watching you?" The girl instantly turns on her lights and looks around, but no one's there. So she unplugs Alexa and is about to go back to sleep when she hears what sounds like a man grunting in her closet. As she's staring at her closet, her Alexa turns back on. Ever wonder what would happen if you stopped sleeping? During World War II, the Russians wanted to find a way to keep their soldiers awake longer. So they came up with this awful experiment where they took prisoners of war, put them in a gas chamber, and then exposed them to experimental drugs to see how long they could keep them awake for. Initially, the drug seemed great. The first 4 days, the subjects were agitated, but were normal. By day five, they stopped interacting with each other and began acting extremely paranoid. On day 9, one of the subjects screamed for so long that he tore his vocal cord. On day 14, they started eating themselves. When they turned off the gas on day 15, all of the subjects began screaming in pain, begging for them to turn the gas back on. When they didn't, they all fell asleep and died. This is why you should always look under the toilet seat before you sit down. In 2003, over a 5-day period in London, 3 women showed up to hospitals with the same mysterious symptoms. They say they woke up with these horrible bite marks on the backs of their legs, and then while they're at the hospital, they become paralyzed and die. Despite their similar symptoms, the women had nothing in common except that they had recently been to the same pub. Authorities immediately shut it down and do a thorough search inside of the pub, but can't find anything deadly, until one of the detectives goes to use the pub's bathroom. As he's about to sit down, he thinks he sees something moving in the toilet, so he gives it a little kick. Hiding in the toilet was one of the world's largest and most poisonous spiders, the Brazilian wandering spider, and now they needed to catch it. This is why you should always be scared of clowns. In 2004, a babysitter had just sat down to watch TV before the parents got back when she noticed something. In the corner of the room was a large clown statue that, no matter how she positioned herself, seemed like it was staring right at her. As she's looking at it, the father calls to check in on the kids. She tells him everything is fine, and right before they're about to hang up, she says, "Why do you have a huge clown statue in your TV room?" There was silence on the phone, and then the father just says, "We don't own a clown statue." She immediately drops the phone, runs upstairs, gets the kids, runs outside, calls the cops. Cops go in and come out with this guy. As the police are taking the clown away, one of the officers comes over to the girl and with a very grim look on his face just says, "We found him underneath one of the kids' beds. He was holding a sharpened screwdriver." This is why you should always change your locks. In 2017, a college girl woke up from a nightmare drenched in sweat and decided to rinse off before going back to sleep. She propped her phone on a shelf, turned on some music, and then hopped in the shower. A few minutes later, she reaches for her phone to change the song, but stops suddenly. Reflected on her phone's screen was a person standing in the middle of her bathroom facing the shower. She somehow kept her composure, turned the water to scalding hot, and then ripped open the curtain and sprayed the intruder in the face. As they howled in pain, she ran past them to her kitchen to get her butcher's knife. In a panic, she can't find her knife, so she just runs out of the apartment and calls the police. The police go in and come out with a crazy-looking woman in handcuffs. One of the officers comes over to the girl and says she used to live here and she had copies of your keys. Then he pauses and looks down and brings up a clear evidence bag that contained her butcher's knife and he says, "Looks like she wanted her apartment back." It's what she finds in the kitchen that's really scary. In the early 90s, a young girl was sleeping in her mom's bed when she suddenly woke up for no reason. She looked at her door and she saw her very affectionate cat kind of meowing down the hall as if someone was coming up to pet it, but she was next to her mom and they were the only ones in the house. The girl shakes her mom awake and points to the cat just as a man is walking past the door and disappears into the room across the hall. Before the man could come back out and find them, they both jump out the window, run across the street, and call the police. When the police arrive, the guy is nowhere to be found, but they do discover that the front door was unlocked, so that had to be the way he got in and out, but the mother swears up and down that she locked that door before she went to bed. A week later, the mother's cleaning their kitchen, and she opens up the water heater closet where she finds this notebook that inside is their names and pictures of them in it, along with a pair of surgical gloves, which means someone had snuck in at some point, was living in that closet spying on them, and then walking around their house at night. This is why you should always lock your doors. A junior in high school was home alone working on a paper while his parents were out to dinner. All night, he sits with his back to his door, sitting at his desk with his noise-canceling headphones on. Around 11 o'clock, he takes his headphones off at the same time his parents are returning to the house, and he hears his mom from downstairs yell, "Hey Adrian, what happened?" Confused, he runs downstairs and sees right away what she's looking at, muddy footprints all over the rug. He tells her, "I didn't leave my desk." And then they realize someone must have broken in. They look at the footprints and there's none leaving the house. They're worried someone's still in the house, so they run into the garage, terrified, call the police. Police arrive and they don't find anyone in the house, but they do make a chilling discovery upstairs. The police bring them to the kids' bedroom door, which had been left open all night, and they point to the message written on it in Sharpie. This is the actual transcript of what was written on his door, which means for nearly 2 hours, someone stood in this kid's doorway watching him.
Warning, you might not be able to sleep tonight. There's a story of a woman they call a monster within. In 2015, a patient began to have headaches and a doctor discovered what they thought was a brain tumor. When they removed it, it had hair, teeth, and bones. Not that bones. There you go. This fell into her brain when she was an embryo and then it began to develop as her life went on. This condition is called teratoma with 20,000 cases a year. And some cases even have eyes in them. Okay, that's enough internet for today. Okay, you won't believe what I found. I just found something extremely dark. If you look at the Texas Department of Criminal Justice website, you'll see death row information. A list of people the government has killed, and you get to see who they are, what their crime was, their last statement, their name, jail number, and even the county they were killed in. Ooh, look, they have career opportunities. Funny thing is, the data is updated in real time, and the last person that was put down was on February 6th, 2020.
Hey, so did you know there was a laughing disease that eventually shut down 14 schools? The world actually had a laughing problem. Near the border of Uganda, there were three girls that started laughing uncontrollably. This spread out to schools and ended up affecting 95 students in the school. Eventually, nearby schools had to shut down because of laughing. This only started to die off after 18 months and 1,000 people were affected.
Okay, hold up. Have you heard of body integrity identity disorder? Do you have it? This is an extremely bizarre medical condition where a patient feels their specific body part should not be there. One man had this disorder and desperately wanted his arm removed. Obviously, normal surgeons can't remove a healthy body part and no one would want to do it. When an actual surgeon in another country finally agreed to do it, this man reported feeling much happier without the limb. Some even report that their limbs feel like a creature that doesn't belong there.
Sometimes reality is stranger than fiction. In 2010, a couple renting a cabin in the middle of the woods finds the guest logbook tucked underneath the bed in the bedroom. After reading through it, they decide to call the cops. The final five entries are all by the same man. The first two are just talking about how great it is to be on vacation with his girlfriend. Then it starts to get weird. In the third entry, he describes a stranger lurking in the tree line that doesn't respond to his waves. In the fourth entry, he hears knocking on the windows in the middle of the night, but no one's there. In his fifth and final entry, his handwriting is barely legible, and it just says, "It's in the bathroom, we're going to die." The police show up and find the girlfriend's body in the basement. Next to her body was her purse, and in her purse was her phone. When they open it up, they see that she texted her mother one last time, and it just says, "Mike's starting to act crazy. I think he's off his meds again."